Hello, I am Russell96, and welcome back to another episode of my Dark Souls 2 playthrough. And we're going to explore this area and hopefully not die. I see a staircase over here, so let's run over here before going down that there ladder, right over that way. And it looks like we might not have much to do this way. Oh, it's a door. Doors normally mean stuff, and stuff normally means fun times. Hello, big guy. You ain't got nothing on me. Give us stamina. Ooh, he still hit me. Oh, that ain't through fire. Wow. Getting all crafty on me, aren't ya? See an item. I'm not sure if those are exploding barrels. So, let's hit them. Be wary of gorgeous view. That is a... There's a tower and everything's all gray. I would have to disagree. I mean, the water looks really good and all that, but there really isn't any landscape. There is some mysterious fog illuminating over there, but nothing too special, I would have to say. Run in and block. Hello. No fire for you. Now you are dead. Okay, let's go up the tower because I don't think I would be able to get back up from jumping down there. So let's run up here, and I forgot to start my timer. But are you guys enjoying the, like, how I'm formatting the episodes where I'm keeping a timer going? What the heck? Or would you... Well, oh god! Whoop, 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 runs away! Or would you guys want me to just keep recording? And then just have very, not really subtle ends to an episode, but just have, like, text zoom in, like, a few seconds before the end of the episode, then cut it from there. Because that would work, and I think I am probably going to end up doing that for one... I don't even... but I probably ended up doing that for an earlier episode because it was getting a bit long and I didn't want to extend it too much and there was a good cutting point. Oh god. Holy crap! That is not natural, that is not normal behavior. Last time I checked, belly flops don't cause explosions. Holy sh... Die! Die! Die now! You crazy, crazy messed up things. Why do you explode when you belly flop on the ground? That is not normal behavior. I hear them, but I do not see them. Hello! Aha, you tried belly flopping. But I sliced you. Oh god, oh god. Hello! That floating pot fragment. Anything in there? It does not appear to be so. Ooh, what's up here? Anything important? Glad I wasn't standing by that. I can break that. You know what I bet I could have done with that there explosive? Well, then again, it exploded when it fell. Let's explode this little iron gate bit. Or see if we can even... Die. Well, no, I don't want to die. I want these guys to die. Yeah, work on my sentence structure a bit more. Well, let's see if we can push this potentially explosive barrel. Darn it. How do you actually push them? Let's run around this corner and see if there's like a lever. Any secret? Wait, what is that? I'll read the muscle. Here. Bloodstain. There has to be a way to open that. Let's just continue on up. Oh, a door that I missed earlier. Hello, item. Skeptic spice. Huh. Nope. What's that do? It's so hard trying to find items that you have no idea what they are. Lowers required faith by one by for chosen spell. Oh god. Rip me. Oh, we found the secret. A chest. Oh, nope. Oh, it opens on the other side. And item. Wilted dusk herb. What the heck does that do? It's very wilted. Restores many spell uses. Cool. It would help if I had spells. Let's go back up. This guy is very chill if he's putting up with that. Is that a lever? No, that was a corpse. slightly different. I might be able to jump down to that ledge right there. I'm just not sure how I would get back out. Let's quickly run back down there to see if there's a lever on the inside to raise the gate. Does not appear to be a lever to raise the gate. I want that item though. Because normally the hard to get items are the good items. I'm not even sure if that gate. It looks like it would move. I don't know. We'll worry about that later, I guess. Let's go up the tower more before we. Woof, 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 bail! Hey! No! 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 Bad. No belly flopping explosions for you, Mr. Weird as Hell Guy. No, you're giving up. No. Alluring Skull. Is that a bonfire? Yes, it. Statue blocks your way. Can I break the statue? No, we cannot. And that door is locked. That is a massive troll. Do we have anything that could potentially do anything with statues? What's this? Temporary boosts dark defense. I don't think we do. Guard break. Huh. That's two statues now. How do we deal with statues? That is the question. Wait, will that lock me out? That bonfire would be a really good thing to have, though. 8 life gems, nice. Oh, hello. Is this another boss fight? We're really far away from a bonfire. How do I open... let's wing it. Sinners Rise. Let's switch back to our halberd. I guarantee there's a way to deal with those statues, or else... Well, by that I mean, like, not in a way that requires you... Oh my god. I'll be right back once I'm back to the same spot. I'll cut back in when I'm on the bridge. Okay, I'm actually just back to this part. But I got that barrel down by that iron fence, so let's shoot it. And it didn't explode it. Aww. I'll be back at the bridge. Okay, I did not realize that the bridge was literally right up the staircase. Get better aim. Wow. I'll wait for a few guys to try and plunge and attack us. Hello. Get murdered. Ow. Holy crap, that did a lot of damage. I will return again. Let's try this again. Guard break attempt? I think it was. Also, the sword got stuck in the ground again, which is always cool. Oh. Got it. Ow. Oh. Shoot your crossbows. Ow. Oh, we gotta kill this guy now. What'd he drop? Heavy crossbow. Cool. Was there anything else past here? An item. Human effigy, yes. Okay, let's go up this ladder before messing with what I assume is an elevator. And I keep forgetting to start my timer. So I really do not have an accurate... What'd I miss? Is a dragon or a drake, and it's a bonfire. Yes. So are the statues just like trolls? Oh god. Ow. Ow. Woohoo! Clutch. Okay. Anything up here besides from a bonfire? Does not appear so, but I will take a bonfire any day. And let's use a life gem instead of Estus. And let's resume our journey. Actually, let's go level up, because we have 19k souls. But, like, what's the deal with the statues? Because I hope whenever I get the thing to make them unstatued, it's really obvious what it is. Seek the lest this and level up more. How close are we to being able to use miracles? Okay, let's put one in each. And then let's just get 10 adaptability to have a little bit more. That doesn't even raise our attunement, does it? Or agility. Let's not raise adaptability anymore. More stamina, I guess. Oh, no. I just leveled up. Travel. Oh, it's a new place. Sinner's Rise. Actually, there was still that one other way we could have went in the Lost Bastille. So let's go back to the Lost Bastille Servant's Quarter, then go down the other way before we continue on with this area. Because I'm not really sure how large it is. And if the other way splits off into, we still have to go down the ladder also. Because I want to finish areas before I go to a separate area. Almost ran right off there. Woohoo, I can dodge, guy. Okay. Oh, let's run. And this is where I want to go next. And dead. I wonder if we can jump over to that other roof. Flaming flame butterfly. What'd that do? Light torch autonomously. Ooh, that jump. Large soul of a nameless soldier. Ah, and that goes up to this part. Let's jump down. At least I think that was the window I saw earlier. An already lit brazier. And a dog. And another dog. And two more dogs. Now three dogs? Keep up the trend. Okay, it doesn't look like it. And this looks like a very large rock. I imagine the corpse that comes up now. Oh god! Did I kill everything? I don't get anything awesome out of that. Aww. I guarantee they put that in there just because of the Estus shard in the Majula. Guarantee that's why they did that. Like, ooh, I get another Estus shard. Nope. So many doors, I don't know which one I want to open. Use antiquated key. Here's a broken cell. One of those weird explodey guys. More flame butterflies. Well, I need a lot of torches soon, because that's what I get out of giving me stuff to light torches. Hello. Gas. Oh, an item. Illyrian skull. Cool. This is a very large... It's another hide night. Let's kill him. Oh, he has a spear. Holy crap! That aggression. Wonder if I could parry him. I don't want to try, though. No. I'll get back to this area again. Okay, I'm back down to where the dogs were, and the dogs were murdering me really, like, a lot. Okay, this is where we went earlier. Oh, item. Royal Swordsman armor, third one of those I got. And item. Illyrian skull. Cool. Okay. Was it anything else over here? Weapon rack. I'm assuming I can't pick up any of those weapons, although that halberd looks nicer than the one I have, and I want it. Just one weird zombie skeleton guy thing left to kill. Let's get him to break this, because I wonder if there's an item on top of it. Go ahead. Swing your big weapon. That was a stab, not a swing. Let's just see if we can break it. Oh, we can. Cool. Okay, hide night murder attempt again. And did I already mention that the dogs kept wrecking me? Like, really badly. There's a door over there, and an impossible to jump gap. Ow. Ooh. I have to give the developers who, like, animated or even just designed these knights' armor, because these guys look cool. And, like, the way they're hunched over, they just, like, peer. It's like, look how cool we are. Look at those attacks. I'll be back to try again. Okay, I'm back here, and I got a few things from enemies. I got a royal greatsword from one of those, like, sword guys. And I really like the moveset. Like, it's a nice stab, then a spin. And I would say the two-handed R2 looks really cool. Like, does that count as a parry also? Then again, it has that. Is this an attack? No, I think that's just a parry. Let's actually quickly check to see if it's any longer than the bastard sword, because it's the same moveset besides the R2s. They look about the same length. They look exactly the same length. What's the scaling? It's a strength weapon, even though it looks more like a dex weapon. Only it requires more dex, but scales less. Interesting. Anyway, let's... Third time's the charm attempt the hide tonight. Let's get our stuff. And murder. Ow. No stabby. That chip damage. God, that attack. Lock! Oh my god. The spear guy is terrible. He's really good, but I'm really terrible at fighting him. I'm gonna try parrying him next time, because I think that might work better. Here we go again! Hopefully. Let's actually heal up fully before we start attacking him, and let's just try and stun lock him. Pain. Okay, now let's heal. No. That attack. Wow. Much pain. Okay. Let's hope we actually get it this time. We just gotta more strategically heal. I think that's what's getting us. Let's actually... Ooh. This might end terribly for us, but... Oh, that did very low damage. We got much more out of that than we did. That chip damage, though. Successful heal was successful. That would have failed if it didn't stun him. Haha, we are the champion! Hide spear. Do we get the cool move set like it does, or he did? Wait, 25 dex, wow. I think we could still test out the spear, or move set rather. This seems like a standard spear to me. I think it's the same, only maybe it has better reach or something like that. It has really good... Oh, spears have good counter damage. That's good. Okay, let's... I think there might have been another door or something else down here, so let's go down here. And there's the other door that goes to the... other way where the dogs were, and then there's a completely different area over chest, like the ladder at the start of the Estus flask chart at the bonfire we're resting at, the ladder that goes down from there. Can we open this gate? Hello, doggy. Stabby, stab, stab. Oh, wait, this is the one blacksmith guy who's really crazy. Oh. So let's rest here, because it's much closer to where we are right now. Oh! Actually, let's go level up. 21k souls just from PvE. Not bad, if I do say so myself. Okay, she's over here now.
Is that a shard you here to see light? However.
Okay, now we got 5 Estus. Good, good, good. Progress is being made. I feel like it's definitely picking up now. Like, it started off fairly slow. Oh. Now we can heal. Let's go buy heal from Melentia. Yeah. Where is she? There she is.
And you?
Buy item. Heal. Now we don't have to use life gems after all of our stuff runs out. Attune spells. Oh, I also got Lingering Flame as a drop from those big mummy scythe guys. But we don't have a pyromancy hand, so we can't really use it. Where did I pick up a tower shield? It must have been in the chest by the one guy. This shield is 100% block? Why have I not been using this? Oh, that's my... How much heavier is it? That's 7. That's... Oh, it's like twice the weight. But it's 100% block instead of 90. Yeah. Wait, how are we so much... Oh, we have like 4 weapons on our guy. Oh, we have 2 shields. That's probably why. Still 72, or still 2% over. Let's just have it handy to switch off to the long sword. Now we're good, and we can put our hat back on. Only we need to equip our sacred chime. Okay, now we can heal ourselves and be all cool like, and let's actually increase our equip load a bit. And it would appear that the the episode is probably done by or done lengthwise by now. I think I messed up the timer a bit this episode. So let's go back to McDuff's workshop. Yep. That is the correct bonfire, and we will continue on in this area next episode. If you enjoyed it, feel free to leave a like, and I'll see you guys next episode. Bye!